everyone, and welcome to our daily devotions for today, Tuesday, the 9th of February. We begin with our opening prayer. Let's pray together. Gracious God, we thank you for the great honour of belonging to Christ and being part of his body. Teach us what that truly means. Help us to contribute to the life of your people through offering our time, our money, our gifts, and our service. Help us to make time for fellowship so that we may know the strength that comes through sharing joys and sorrows, through joining in prayer and in worship, and by learning through the experience of others. Help us to appreciate the enrichment that comes through being an active member of your family. And so may we make that membership more real day by day through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Luke chapter 8. After this, Jesus travelled about from one town and village to another, proclaiming the good news of the kingdom of God. The 12 were with him, and also some women who had been cured of evil spirits and diseases. Mary, called Magdalene, from whom 7 demons had come out. Joanna, the wife of Chuza, the manager of Herod's household. Susanna, and many others. These women were helping to support them out of their own means.
We're focusing today on the ministry of Jesus, and in particular, on the way in which he went from place to place, curing people as he travelled with the 12 disciples. But he also had with him the women who were helping to support them all out of their own means. We sing together, "The kingdom of God is justice and joy."
Psalm 74. Remember how the enemy has mocked you, Lord, how foolish people have reviled your name. Do not hand over the life of your dove to wild beasts. Do not forget the lives of your afflicted people forever. Have regard for your covenant, because haunts of violence fill the dark places of the land. Do not let the oppressed retreat in disgrace. May the poor and needy praise your name. Rise up, O God, and defend your cause. Remember how fools mock you all day long. Do not ignore the clamor of your adversaries, the uproar of your enemies, which rises continually.
We come now to our closing prayer for today. Let's pray together. Sovereign God, we praise you for the strength you have shown across the centuries, working in circumstances that seem hopeless and through people who seemed powerless to do anything. We praise you that you are able to transform situations in a manner that defies human logic, giving strength to the weak and achieving great things that look to us to be absolutely impossible. Teach us never to measure situations by the way things seem, and never to avoid a challenge because we feel unable to meet it. Help us to look to you and to trust in your strength that is stronger than any earthly power, recognizing that whatever you set out to accomplish, you will do through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
I give glory to the Lamb.